Hey there everyone, welcome to another video of Fox Android. So in this video we're going to learn how to implement a recycler view into our Android application using Java as the backend language, right? If you want to implement the same using Kotlin, I already have a video on that. You can check that video as well. I'll put the link in the description below, right? So let me just give you a brief demonstration of what we're going to get by the end of this video. So if you can see on my mobile screen, I have this activity which imitates the news app, right? So basically it has headlines, and for each headline it has an image on the left hand side. So if I just scroll up and down, we can see various news items inside a recycler view. So this is what we'll be designing. If you want to implement the same to your Android application, make sure you watch this video till the end. So without much ado, let's get started. So guys, if you're new to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and press the bell notification icon for receiving notification of the upcoming videos. And by the end of the video, if you like the video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button as well. So let's start with the development. So basically this is the activity where we are going to implement the recycler view, right? So let's go with the front end part. Let me just delete this text view, and we're gonna insert a recycler view here. We'll constrain it to the parent on all the sides, and let us just give it ID. So let me just call it as recycler view only, right? The ID for this. And now to put the items in the recycler view, we need to create a new layout resource file, right? That would have the design for the individual item that this recycler view will contain. So for that, just right click here, go to new layout resource file, and here we'll just name it as list item, right? You can give it a name according to your requirement, and let's just click OK. So let me just quickly design this layout, right? Then I'll explain what we have done. So okay guys, we are done with the designing part, right? Basically we have took a shapeable image view to show the title image for the news headline, right? Then we have a text view which will just indicate the headline. Then this view is taken just to show the underline below every heading to separate the headings from each other, right? So let me just show you one thing. So here I've used a shape appearance overlay. So if you can see, the corners of this image are round. For that I've used a style that I've already designed. So in case you want to use that as well, so let me just go to themes, just include this style, right? You have to write it yourself, right? Name it round corner and put in these attributes, then use it here, you'll get round corners. And for this view I've used the background color as underline, so the color code for that is this one. You can use this color code, right? So that is all we need to do in the front end part. So let's go to the back end code. So in here, for storing the data of the particular item, right? For example, in my case, I have an image and a heading, basically a text view. So I have to store two things for particular list item. For that, we have to create a model class. So let me just right click here, new Java class. I'll name it as news. Now here you need to declare all the variables that you will be using to store the data for that particular elements. So in my case, I have a string variable to store the heading, and an int variable to store the source ID of the image, right? So let me just name it as title image. And in this case, I'll be using certain images from my drawable folder, right? So I'll paste those image from my local device. So let me just copy all those images from the local device and paste it into the drawable folder. And let us try to use that here in the image view. If I just put the source of the image, here you can see this is the image, right? So here we have declared these variables. Now we need to create a constructor for this class. So just right click, generate constructor, select both the elements, press shift and down key. Okay, so we have got the constructor. That is all we need to do in the model class. You can change the number of variables here, right, according to your application. Now to feed the data to the recycler view, we'll be using a adapter, right, recycler view adapter. So for that, we'll create a new Java class. I'll just name it as my adapter. Now this class will extend recycler view dot adapter, and here we'll just pass my view holder. Right, now we need to implement certain methods. So for that, just click here, alt enter, implement methods, click OK. So we have got the methods. Now we have to create inner class. So public static class, and we'll just name it as my view holder. Make sure the name of this class is same as we have written here, right? Now it will extend recycler view dot view holder. Now we have to create a constructor for this. So click here, alt enter, create constructor matching super, right? So now we need to create a constructor for this class as well. So that constructor will take two arguments. The very first one will be the context, and the second one will be a array list. And it will contain the elements of news class. So news array list. Now right click here, generate constructor, select both the elements, click OK. We have got the constructor here. So inside this method, get item count will return news array list dot size. Now inside this my view holder class, we need to refer to all the elements that we want to populate in the cycler view, right? For example, in my case, I have these two elements, the image view and this text view, right? I want to put in the data in these two views. So for that, I'll just come here. I'll quickly just refer to all the two elements, right? So here we have referred to both the elements using find view by id, right? Now we'll just go to this on create view holder. So here we'll create a view class reference variable, and we'll use layout inflator dot from, and we'll pass the context of the activity dot inflate. Now here we'll pass the layout, this particular layout that we have created. And here we'll return the object of this inner class. So new my view holder, and we'll pass this particular view as an argument, right? So the last method we need to overwrite is this onBind view holder. So we'll get the object from this particular array list, right? According to the position of this cycler view, that we'll get here as an argument. And now we'll populate these two fields, right? TV heading and title image. Okay, we have set both the elements, the heading and the title image. So that is all we need to do inside this class, my adapter class. Now we'll go to the main activity, right? Java file of main activity. So we'll go here, and here we need to define certain variables. So let me just quickly do that. Okay, let us just refer to the cycler view. So cycler view is equal to find view by id. The id for that is recycler view only, and let us just set certain attributes for this. Now let us just initialize this array list. And let us create the object for the adapter class, and we'll pass the context here and this array list. So we'll set this adapter to the cycler view. Now for getting the news heading, I'll be using the static data. For the image, we have these images inside the drawable folder, and for the heading, we'll put all the headings inside this array, right? String array. So for that, so I have all the headings written inside a text file in my device, so that will save some time. So I'll just copy it from there and paste it here. So okay, we have got all the headings inside this string variable. And now we'll store the source IDs of these images inside this array, the int array, right? So, okay, we have got all the image resource IDs here. After that, we are going to call a method. Get data, don't worry about it, we'll just create it in a while. So click here, create method, right? So inside this method, we'll put the data inside this array list, this whole data, right? So for that, I'll be using a for loop. Okay, we have added all the elements from these two arrays inside the news array list, right? And then we have called this myAdapter.notifyDatasetChange. So basically what it will do is it will tell the adapter that some data has been changed and you need to refresh yourself, right? So that is pretty much everything we need to do to implement this cycler view. So let me just quickly install this app to my cell phone and check if it is working fine or not, right? So guys, the app has been installed to my cell phone. As you can see on my mobile screen, we have got all the items inside the cycler view, right? We have got all the pictures along with the headlines in the cycler view, right? So I guess we have successfully implemented this to our Android application, and I also hope that you guys have understood the code. In case of any doubt, you can always ask me in the comment section or you can DM me on Instagram. The Instagram username will be there on your screen right now. And if you like the video, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button. And in case you are new to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and press the bell notification icon for receiving notification of the upcoming videos. So that is it for today's video. See you in another video. Bye.